rise among the saints. My gaze transfixed on Jesus' face. Oh, praise the name of the Lord our God. Oh, praise the name forevermore, for endless days. We will sing your praise, oh Lord, oh Lord our God. Oh Lord, oh Lord our God.
Oh Lord, oh Lord our God.
Right, so that's the one we might be doing acoustically in the later time. That probably works quite well for that.
How much time have you got?
None. Benediction.
May the peace, this understanding, and this grace which makes us what we are, and the fellowship of bitterness, and the warmth in spirit and in heart. And to him be praise for his glorious reign. From the depths of earth to the lips of heaven, we declare the name of the Lamb once slain, Christ eternal, the King of Kings. Lift up, arise, lift up, arise, you're the giver of life. Lift up, arise, lift up, arise, you're the giver of life. Lift up, arise, lift up, arise, you're the giver of life. We lift up, arise.
Got this one.
Right, good morning. Needs to come off the... Okay. Right, good morning everyone. A very warm welcome to you all. And hang on a moment. Normal service will be resumed in a moment. But very warm welcome to you all to our Church for All and Messy Church, all combined. Now, we will explain as we go along what will be taking place, but part of the service will all be together. And then whilst the craft is taking place later on, so about halfway through the service, That was interesting. Whilst the craft is going on, for those who want to, for the adults, they can either stay and do craft, or they can come with me to the Lady Chapel, and in there we'll have the Bible talk and some prayers and one song, hopefully. And then we'll come back and we'll all join together in a song at the end. And for Christine's purposes, that's when the collection will be brought up, during the final song. So I'm going to, just by way of notices, if you just scroll on one more, I think, maybe. Right, okay, by way of notices, thank you to everyone who has delivered Easter leaflets. That's fantastic. If you are able to, there are just a few bundles left. If you want to take some this week, if you don't, I'm certain we'll cope. This week, there's Maundy Thursday, we have a communion service at 7:30 in the evening. Good Friday, there's a walk of witness, so that's outside, meeting at the Top Shops, and that's at 10 o'clock, and that'll be followed by hot cross buns in the vicarage. And then, Celia didn't know about that yesterday. And then, well, you never know. Just commissioning you to another lot of hot cross buns. But don't worry, it's Good Friday. Then on Easter Day we have,
Ian?
Yes?
Could we just say something about the walk on Good Friday morning? Because it's great to see a number of new people. They may not have been on this before, but basically what we do is we walk down the high street and we stop at different places and explore part of the Easter story. And we finish up in the lay-by at a cross, and we've got one or two emblems that remind us of Easter. So if you haven't been before, it's a way of exploring something very seasonal, the Easter story, and showing why Good Friday was such a special day. Thank you, Ian. Great. Sorry to interrupt.
No, that's fine. And then at 2 o'clock, Good Friday, we have an hour at the cross, and the Archdeacon is coming to do that. That's here in church at 2 o'clock. Then Easter Day, 8 o'clock, and then our Easter celebration with Family Communion at 10:30. And the next Messy Church is on the 21st of May. So, without further ado, let me publish the bands of marriage. These are a couple of folk getting married, who are Jake Peter White, of the parish of Holy Trinity, Longglovers, Wootton, St. Mary, without, and with a qualifying connection here. And then Lauren Stella Dobbin, also of the parish of Holy Trinity, Longglovers, Wootton, St. Mary, without, also with a qualifying connection here. So this is for the first time of asking. If any of you know any reason in law why they may not marry each other, you are to declare it. So we're going to pray for Jake and Lauren. Pray for your blessing upon them both as they prepare for their wedding day. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. What a lovely amen from Grace. Fantastic. So today is something called Palm Sunday, which is why you've made palms to wave. And today we're going to see how King Jesus comes into Jerusalem at the start of Easter week, and how the people shouted, and they shouted this. They shouted, God bless the King who comes in the name of the Lord. So our first song is going to be a song that celebrates King Jesus. So let's stand to sing. Come on and celebrate.
Thank you.
of love we will celebrate.
Think what an idiot I must look on live stream. Fantastic, do sit down. And again, a reminder of what the people shouted. They said to Jesus, God bless the King, Jesus, who comes in the name of the Lord. So our next little song has some actions, and it sums up the whole of the Easter story in a very, very simple way. And it's called, Lord, I lift your name on high. I love to sing your praises. I'm glad you're in my life. I'm glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. And that is just the whole of the Easter story in one very simple song. So let's stand to sing. Sunday, Jesus is riding into Jerusalem on a donkey. All the crowds are really pleased to see him. When Jesus came near Jerusalem, at the place where the road went down to the Mount of Olives, a large crowd, like we've got a crowd here, maybe even bigger, a large crowd praised Jesus in loud voices for the great things they'd seen. God bless the King who comes in the name of the Lord. So in our true Bible story, so when we say Bible story, it's not a made-up story, it's true. It really happened. In our true Bible story today, we see how Jesus arrives in Jerusalem at the start of that first Easter week. And lots of people are really excited, like we are today. Why do you think they're excited about Jesus? What have they seen about him that makes them excited? Theo? Perfect, because God is on earth and he's done loads of miracles. He's made poorly people better. He's even made dead people come back to life. And do you know what? The other lovely thing he's done is he's made friends with people who didn't have any friends. Isn't that fantastic? So the people then thought that Jesus might be the special king that Jesus, that God promised hundreds of years earlier. That special king who's going to come back and make all the bad and sad things that have happened, in a minute, darling, since the that sad beginning when people decided they didn't want God to be king, but they wanted to do their own thing. So that sad beginning all thousands of years ago, that they think that Jesus might be that promised king who's coming back to make all those sad and bad things better. And yes, you know, Jesus is that promised king, but he's not going to do things in the way we expect. What should a king sit on? Hands up. What should a king sit on? Yeah. A big special golden throne. Do you know, Jesus was nailed to a wooden cross. What should a king wear on his head? Yes. A big golden crown. Yeah, thank you. Sorry, darling. I didn't get to you in time. And what does Jesus have on his head instead? Yep. Perfect. Yes. He has a crown of thorns. So Jesus is doing this because he loves us and he's dying to make us friends with God. And he promises that one day he'll come back again as a great king to put all the sad and bad things right. So I'm going to say a quick prayer. And I'm going to say, Lord Jesus, thank you that you're our king. You're that special king that was sent. Thank you that you showed your kingship by dying on the cross. And thank you that if we follow you, we can be friends with God. Amen. Right. Oh, amen, Grace. That is a fantastic amen. So in a minute, we are going to have our very own procession. Oopsie. If you want to, you can follow me around church waving your palm branches. Or if you're feeling a little more, I want to sit in my seat, sit in your seats and wave them. And after that, straight after that, the children are going to do, and any grown-ups that want to, we're going to be doing leaf bashing with Libby in the porch. So if you've never done leaf bashing before, it's called Happer. What is it?
Happer Zone.
Oh, Libby, do you want to just come up and show? You're going to be making these beautiful creations. And Libby's found the link because it is Palm Sunday and palms and leaves. So Libby very cleverly got the link. We're going to be making Easter nests.
Oh, can you eat that?
And hot cross buns to eat afterwards. And we're going to be decorating. That's with me and Pete. Pete, give us a wave wherever you are. There. Can you? Me and Pete? Yes, and with Abigail and other half of Pete, thank you. We are going to be doing various salt dough, don't try and eat them, salt dough eggs. With thanks to Bethan for her egg cutter, very handy. So,
and then at the end of the procession, the adults who want to come and join with me in the Lady Chapel, if you don't want to do crafts, I mean, you can stay exactly where you are, or you can come through with me and we'll have a look a bit more about Palm Sunday and what it means for us.
Okay, so, and then the theory is at 10:11:25, precisely.
On the dot.
We are going to regroup, and the music group are going to sing a grace with us, which is a really lovely way.
A grace.
Oh, like grace, yes. It's a lovely way to finish our time together. So I'll try and keep an eye on the time, if I can find my watch. So, how about you join up, those that want to be a procession, join up behind me. And those that don't want to be a procession, just sit and join in with the singing. Okay, so Grace, are you and me going to lead the procession? Could you put my glasses away? Okay, so join up behind me. And we're going to be a very enthusiastic procession. Are you ready, Fliss? got you. Can you wave your banner here then?
And now, how does this, just before we start, how does this song go? Can you just give us a verse?
It's quite, it's like a, you'll know the tune. Oh, I better mute myself.
We have a king who rides on a donkey. We have a king who rides a donkey. We have a king who rides a donkey.
Okay, if those who would like to look a bit more at the Easter, the Palm Sunday story, like to come through to the Lady Chapel. We're aiming to do one song.
You're in straight away now.
No. Being a sheepdog. Ah, right. Jesus thought he was doing on that first Palm Sunday, and then at what the crowd and the disciples thought they were doing on that first Palm Sunday, and then what do we think we're doing as we come to church, as we take our palm crosses, as we remember that first Palm Sunday. So let's just pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for the opportunity to look afresh at the events of Palm Sunday. We pray that you will speak to us afresh and help us to understand what it is you are calling us to do and how to respond. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, there is an opportunity to interact, i.e. you can ask questions or make comments or say no or whatever, but you are not to make any comments, so you don't have to interact. There's no compulsion. I move myself back a little bit. That's very true. They won't hear on the live stream. So as they tie it. those words. They're probably familiar to most, if not all, of us. We've And a few adults who didn't mind making a fool of themselves were going round the church. We were processing and singing God's praise. But was this just a spontaneous act from the crowd? Did this just happen to take place from Jesus' point of view, or was there a plan behind it? We can begin right at the beginning of Mark's account, and we can see that Jesus was intentional in the direction of his travel throughout his ministry. He wastes even a moment. His healings were there for a purpose, not as an end in itself. At the beginning of Mark's account, Jesus actually said to his disciples who came to him early in the morning, saying, "Everybody's looking for you." In other words, there's crowds more people who want the first century version of the national health, which Jesus was fast becoming. And Jesus said, "No, I must go on. It's not that I don't care, but I have a bigger and greater purpose for the whole of humanity before me and after me and now. And if I just spend my time healing, that greater purpose won't take place." And so, sorry, we should have done that. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to greater purpose out as we get to this passage. Because in this passage, we have the example of Jesus preparing in advance. He sent two of his disciples, and what happened? Was it just, "Oh, well, but if there isn't one available, never mind, we'll do without"? Jesus had prepared. We don't know in what way. We don't know whether he'd visited in advance or whether he just used his divine power to make the owner of the animal willing. Jesus was going on the path that he had prepared. The chapters beforehand, immediately beforehand, Jesus says, "I'm going up to Jerusalem, and there I'm going to be mistreated, arrested, scourged, crucified, and die and be buried, and after 3 days rise again." And Peter, one of his disciples, says, no, this can't possibly happen. How can you let this happen to you? Because deep down in Peter, in all the disciples, and for that matter in the crowd, was this default view. The Messiah must be, cannot but be, the one who will remove the Roman threat from us. We're under oppression, we need a savior, therefore the Messiah who's been promised for generations, he cannot but be the one who will get rid of the Romans. That sort of default thinking was going on in the disciples, which is why James and John, in the previous chapter to this, come up to Jesus and say, "Excuse me, but have the best seats, one on the right and one on the left." This sort of coup was about to happen, and they were jostling for places at the top.
"For us, you're the brightest, you will lead us through the storm."
The man didn't come to be served, but to serve and give his life as a ransom for many. Now, they still didn't understand. on that day. And as we come to the sort of second issue, what were the disciples thinking? What were the crowd thinking that day? As they mouthed these words, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our father David. Hosanna in the highest heaven. These were all statements. In effect, writing their own text upon them, and that text being, it must mean Jesus is coming to get rid of the Romans. Because if they truly understood what Jesus was about, then come people, at least a few, would have stood against the chief priests and not said, no, don't crucify him. There was no opposition to his crucifixion at all. It all just happened. And the crowd shouted, crucify. I can't prove that there were the same people present. You know, there might have been 2 million people in and around Jerusalem at the time of the Passover. But there can't have been none around that day. The sheer quantity of crowds that were welcoming Jesus in. So what are we left with? We have disciples and a crowd who are saying, you know, you're the lovely time, that golden age, when everything was in effect. It's a bit like people looking back in this country to the age of empire, when Britain was great and everything else. That's what people looked back to. They looked back to the time of David and Solomon, when the people of Israel were, in effect, the superpower of the area. They'd got it made, and they'd got this fantastic temple, and then everything had gone wrong. And so they were all looking forward my gifts, my time, my energy at your disposal, and allow you to come to me and say, in effect, the Lord has need of you, has need of your gifts, of your time, of your energy. He won't take it forever. As he said to the owner of the donkey, he will send it back shortly. What God takes when we offer to him is always given back and more. We gain more in life the more we give to God. But are we going to be available? Weren't working out as they'd planned. And sometimes has a comment or a... You get little hints of what was going on in the gospel accounts, because the messianic pretenders, sorry to use some long words, but there are quite a lot of people who claim to be Messiah in that 400 year period from when the Old Testament finished and before John the Baptist appeared. There was 400 years of silence, and in that period there were quite a number of people who presented themselves as the Messiah type figure. And what they tended to do was they'd meet in the wilderness, gather together a big crowd, and then march on Jerusalem. And if you look in John's account of the feeding of the 5,000, there is it was a classic example of gather a crowd together. That's what some of the people thought. So Jesus was very carefully avoiding that conclusion coming upon him, which is why he absented himself at that very point. For the Jews arriving, verse about horses of war. So whilst Pilate may not have been aware of that nuance, let's put it that way, Jesus arrives and then this deflates all the emotion. And I think Pilate had to be very careful that he didn't cause a riot, he didn't inflame a riot, because it was easier to let it not happen than to quell it afterwards. But if he tried to intervene, he was on a knife edge, because he'd already blotted good position, which is what a short rope, let's put it that way, if that's the right term. So yes, you're right, Frank, in saying he small number of troops in Jerusalem in comparison to the 2 million people, and if he'd allowed something to develop, he was a master politician, but reflect Peter, possibly.
Flights and fences.
Ah, right. In the middle. Back in the middle.
I am switched on. Okay, so that's kind of the end of our formal time. There is tea and coffee and homemade, hand-glazed with home-produced honey, hot cross buns. And I'm sure children, youngsters, I'm sure the grown-ups would love to see some of the things you've done. They look absolutely beautiful. I am so impressed. But just to finish our formal time, we're going to sing something we call a blessing. We're going to sing each other. A blessing is just basically saying, may God give you all the good things that you need. So we're going to sing that to each other as we finish our formal time together.
And during this...
Oh, the collection. The collection.
...will be received. And there's the card machine for afterwards.
But you've given just by being here. It's been lovely to see you. Thank you for joining in with this experiment.
Yes.
Okay, let's... Peace of God to each other.
Do more crafts.